TaleForges. In today's tutorial, we'll learn how to implement the camera so that it can follow player transform from within the ECS code. So let's dive in and see how it's done. First, let's add the Cinemachine package, as I want to use the camera to follow the player. Let's go to Window, Package Manager, and search for Cinemachine. Download the package. Here is an editor error, which you can ignore. So let's create a virtual camera. Right-click in Hierarchy, Cinemachine, Virtual Camera. Let's reset transform and change body to framing transposer so we get smooth 2D camera movement, and reset X, Y, Z damping. Set camera distance to say 30. Set aim to do nothing. Also select tag main camera for virtual camera, remove this tag from main camera object. As you can see, the Cinemachine brain component responsible for managing the main camera has appeared. We'll leave it unchanged. So time for coding. Okay, let's remove the DestroyEntity from PlayerMovementSystem. We don't need it anymore. Let's create a new partial class, PlayerCameraSystem, that inherits from SystemBase, as we will be performing manage operations, and of course implement the onCreate, onUpdate, and onDestroy methods. Then add attribute, updateInGroup, type of SimulationSystemGroup. Before we get any further, to improve readability, let's refactor the name PlayerAnimationComponentData to PlayerManageComponentData. It's much clearer. Also, let's add a game object and transform to the component and pass them at the time of creation, ES, in the PlayerVisualizationSystem. We can remove the ECB here along with the method and use state.entityManager. .addComponentObject. Let's correct the naming. Now we can delete the game object directly in the PlayerAnimationCleanupSystem. Alright, let's go back to the PlayerCameraSystem class. First of all, let's add PlayerEntityQuery, from which we'll get the PlayerManageComponentData component. Let's not forget to add require for update. In the onUpdate method, we want to set the follow of our virtual camera, so we will use the main camera tag. So let's create virtual camera variable and then write if virtual camera is not null, return. Now we need to find camera object, so virtual camera equals gameObject.findGameObjectWithTag. Main camera dot get component Cinemachine virtual camera. Although this is not a very efficient method, it's enough if we only need to do it once. Next, we'll retrieve the player managed component data from entity query. And at the very end, all we need to do is set virtual camera dot follow to player managed component data dot transform. Let's go back to Unity and test this feature. Wait for the recompile process to finish. Press play. And, as you can see, virtual camera is correctly following the player. I warmly invite you to support us on the Patreon, where I share the code from the recordings and post the ECS videos beforehand. And to all the supporters, thank you. We really appreciate your support. Thank you for your time. See you in the next exciting video. So stay tuned and bye.